In the closing moments of Game 6, Derek Fisher took a little extra time to leave the floor, perhaps pondering what's next for the 18-year veteran. When asked if he will retire and coach or perhaps play again, this is what he said. Quote, there's for sure huge layers added to the decision, the personal relationship and the professional relationship that I've had with Phil Jackson over the years and being in the position that he's in, and also with the Lakers having an opening. It for sure adds layers to it. Kevin Durant has said that Derek Fisher is arguably one of the most important voices in their locker room. If the Thunder ask him to return, should he do it? Stephen A., question's yours.
Hell no. You've been there long enough. You were there a couple years ago when you lost in the finals. You were there this time when you came up short. Derek Fisher is an important piece to any team that he's on simply because of the leadership that he's able to provide in the locker room, along with some big shots that he's capable of hitting and the kind of defense he can provide. It's not about Derek Fisher being still capable of playing in the NBA. We know that he can. The issue is that what's to the betterment of his future?
Right.
What are you going to do? Add a different title to Oklahoma City? So what? In the end, what it comes down to is that you got five rings from the Lakers. Derek Fisher's fine. Derek Fisher's a champion five times over. Derek Fisher's somebody that has been around for it all. And his greatest years were with the Los Angeles Lakers. All you can do is help a young team get over the hump. Mm-hmm. But that's about it. And you don't allow that to usurp your own future. Derek Fisher is in an incredibly ideal situation right now. Yes, he wants to be an executive in the NBA someday, but he understands that the road he may need to take is the same role Pat Riley took as it pertains to becoming a coach first and then an executive later. Okay, Larry Bird did that. Isaiah Thomas did that. Clearly, you know, when you look at those guys. And what they did, and Pat Riley, he wants to follow that path in terms of being a coach first, if that's the choice he has to make, because he ain't going to just get an executive job. So if that's the case, New York and L.A. are open. How many times is that going to happen for you? How many times are the dominoes going to fall in your favor with that? In New York, there's Phil Jackson, the man you won five rings for.
Right.
All right? And in L.A., it's L.A., the franchise. That you want it with. What's there to talk about here? You have an opportunity, and I'm not saying that he's a prime candidate for the LA job. I know he is for the Knicks job. But what I'm saying is that if you have an opportunity in those two places, that's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, because even if the position itself presents itself, it's rare in the day, if ever, that both markets are open for you at the same time.
Right.
You got to take advantage of that. You don't sacrifice that to go back to Oklahoma City.
So you can have something against Oklahoma City?
Well, I'm not gonna have anything against Oklahoma City other than the fact that, you know what, the airlines could have adjusted and made sure more flights flew in and out of there,
yeah, knowing that it was not a conference finals.
I understand that, but damn it, if your airport was bigger, maybe they would have. But I mean, don't get me started, okay? I'm here, am I not? I'm here this morning. You know what I went through yesterday.
Travel trouble.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah, I know.
Are you kidding me? I mean, don't get me started, please.
True.
All right, but the people are very nice, and the basketball environment is great. Downtown area is a little bit left to be desired, but that's a different subject for another day.
I grew up there and I went downtown. I can count on one hand how many times.
I saw why.
Okay.
I saw why. But with that being said,
you're
going to pass up New York?
No.
And L.A. to go and play one more year with Oklahoma City when your future could very well be for the next 15 to 20 years if you take the right job in New York or L.A.? What's there to think about? You got to think about the marathon, not the sprint.
Okay, I have two answers to this question.
Okay.
Before I get to your question, I want to point out, in fairness, you were extremely hard on Steve Kerr with no coaching experience.
Oh.
Suddenly being sought by, wait a second, the Knicks and the Warriors and whoever else is in the mix?
Right.
Well, I could say the same thing about Derek Fisher right now. Who the heck is Derek Fisher to be sought by the Los Angeles Lakers and the New York Knickerbockers?
Okay.
I mean, who gets that? That's not just once in his lifetime. That's once in anybody's lifetime. What did Derek Fisher do to deserve to have two? I don't know about the Lakers job, but the LA Times reported that he's
I'll
a
answer
candidate.
That in a minute. Go ahead.
Okay. But that. Okay. Suddenly he's the golden boy, right?
Yeah.
All right, is that fair?
No. But go ahead.
Well, it is, because boy, has he coached one
Before?
Minute of any game in his life? I don't think so.
Right.
I might be wrong.
No.
Okay, now back to playing. It is no small decision for a man who has played basketball his entire life to suddenly walk away from it, even at age 39. And I'm going to point out to you, guess who for the Oklahoma City Thunder played every minute of the fourth quarter and every minute of overtime? Derek Fisher. The other night in Game 6, played all the whole fourth quarter and all the whole overtime. What does that tell you? He became pretty valuable to them. I thought his body looked sensational for a 39-year-old body. He looked stronger than ever, played defense tougher than ever. He got rocked on that pick, I don't know if we have that, by Tim Duncan, which, you know, it was a moving pick. It was an offensive foul, but again, Ginobili had been robbed on the goaltend call that right. should have been goaltending, so I just said, okay, I'll look the other way on that one. But again, Derek Fisher was causing the Spurs a lot of trouble on defense, because he provides some toughness to that team that others don't provide. And I think he did become a leader of that team in the locker room, maybe the leader. So do they want him back? I'll bet they do want him back. Could I, in good conscience, say, hey, just walk away from that? No, I don't think it's that simple, even though it is a once-in-anybody's-lifetime opportunity maybe to have the Knicks and the Lakers. But to me, if you're playing at that high a level that you can finish a game for the Oklahoma City Thunder at 39, far be it for me to say, I'll walk away from that, because you know how much it means to those guys to finish playing. You think Derek Fisher will ever be as happy as a coach or an executive as he was as a player? I don't think so. And he has a chance to return as a pretty important cog to a team that next year may be picked to win it all. I don't know. They'll probably be picked to win the West, depending on, you know, if Duncan and company win it, would Tim retire next year? He might. He might.
Couple of things. Mm-hmm. Point number one. Let's get back to your point about Steve Kerr. If you remember, the point that I made about Steve Kerr was, it wasn't the fact that he had one or two jobs available to him. If Chicago or San Antonio had come calling, teams he's mm-hmm. won championships with, and you saw the connection, I understood it. All right? Or New York with Phil Jackson, I understood it. The issue that I had with Steve Kerr, as I took the liberty of explaining to mm-hmm. him when we saw each other this weekend, was that his name was mentioned for every daggone job. And I was like, what does somebody with no coaching experience done to deserve that? And to his credit, he and I had a wonderful conversation, and we're absolutely fine. But that was my issue with Steve Kerr. It wasn't that it was one or two jobs that were open. It was that every sure. single opening that occurred, even in Utah, you heard his name.
You did.
And that don't happen for black coaches. Okay. That was my statement. That's number one. Number two, as it pertains to Derek Fisher, when you won the championships with the Lakers and you won it with Phil Jackson coaching. Phil Jackson just happens to be in New York. So that's the only two jobs that his name has been associated with. Not every job. The franchise he won the championships with, plus his relationship with Kobe, okay? And plus the coach he won it for, who now happens to be the boss in New York. And by the way, who has told people he would be coaching in training camp and he would be running training camp or whatever. And so you're talking about being tutored by the very man who coached you to five championships. So Derek Fisher being in that situation is a tad bit different than Steve Kerr, because Derek Fisher isn't being mentioned with every damn opening where Steve Kerr was. Now, let's get to the point about basketball. Derek Fisher in Oklahoma City, of course they should want him. I'm saying if you're Derek Fisher, you're 40. In the end, it's coming to an end. You need to be thinking about your future. Do you want a job in Utah someday? Do you want the Indiana job or something like that? No. If Derek Fisher were to coach anywhere, he'd want it to be in New York or L.A., the two largest markets in the United States. And by the way, coaching either under the coach that's an 11-time champion that would literally teach him the game, or coaching for the franchise he helped to mm-hmm. five championships. So if you're looking at it from that perspective, plus you have aspirations as a former executive, as a former president of the Players Association, to be an executive in the game, then excuse me, you're talking about a new career move that's going to be relatively lucrative, that could end up lasting you the next 20 years. Do you pass that up to go one more year in Oklahoma City? No, you don't.
How do you know it's just one more year? I don't know that.
Well, I'm saying to you that, okay, one or two, Skip, the dude is in shape or whatever, but the dude is going to be, I mean, if he's not 40, right? I don't know his birthday. I got to look it up, but Skip, he's 40.
He'll play at 40 next
year. He'll play at 40. Mm-hmm. He would play at 40. Mm-hmm. There ain't but so much time left. He knows that. He knows that. His wife knows it. Everybody knows. His friends know it. His mama knows. Everybody knows. It's going to come to an end. Bottom line is this. No matter when it ends, it ain't going to be as long as your next career.
No.
And so if that next career has an opportunity to be in New York or L.A.,
yeah,
what's there to think about?
Yeah, he turns 40 August 9th.
What's there to think about?
You've talked to these analysts up here.
Yep.
We have to walk away because most of them get forced to walk away.
Yep.
They never quite can give up on it because it's always in their blood. It never makes them quite as happy to talk about the games here as it did to play.
Yeah, but they acknowledge that the hard part to resist is the game, the allure, the crowd, you know, the fervor, not the conditioning it takes to be all right then. So what I'm saying to you is that they can sit there and talk about how much they miss it all they want to,
now,
but it don't stop them from eating Twinkies in a cab.
Okay. No, I get it. But I don't know. You know Derek better than I do.
Yes, I do.
But if he's tired of the conditioning or of the practicing or of the meetings, that's all another. I don't
see. You don't see it. But I'm telling you, it's just that Derek Fisher is a pragmatist, and his wife, Candace, is definitely a pragmatist. They understand that it's coming to an end. So if the opportunities present itself, Derek Fisher is highly intelligent. He's incredibly poised and composed. And he's got the temperament under the right situation to really have a successful career. I'm not sure whether it's going to be as a coach or as an executive, but I'm certain he won't fail at both. So he's looking for an opportunity that extends beyond the game. You don't pass that up to go back to Oklahoma City for 1 year.
No matter what,
honestly,
Derek,
I think he could be a better coach than
anybody.
Steve Kerr.
No matter what he decides, Derek Fisher, as we just noted, has played the most playoff games in NBA history. So he'll be good on either side. Coming up next, we're talking about LeBron James. He's headed to his fourth straight finals. I don't know if you've heard about that. Is he really the greatest? This is a serious question. It says greatest ever, question mark. Are you ready to weigh in? Clearing throat. That was Skip Bayless. We'll talk about it.